Going back to financial markets now, the Philippine benchmark index bucks the regional downsizing. It closed higher at 66.02. Now, value turnover was also good at 5.1 billion pesos. This comes ahead of the release of the Philippines' December inflation data, which will be out tomorrow. That's Friday. The consensus, inflation slightly picked up in December amid strong holiday spending. The central bank predicting the rate to settle between 3.6 to 4.4%. Citing higher prices of rice and meat, inflation was at 4.1% in November. The BSP widely expected to mirror the Federal Reserve's moves this year, with rate cuts seen before the year is out. The central bank has been one of the most aggressive in tightening rates in the past 2 years, hiking by 450 points to 6.5% in its battle against inflation. Now, the local bourse did okay today. Jaffet Antianco of Fieldstax Financials will analyze the market for us, as well as tackle some data, particularly December inflation set for release tomorrow, and how the market is going to price that in. Jaffet, Happy New Year and welcome again to the Business Roadshow.
Happy New Year, Stanley. Thank you very much for inviting me.
All right. Today we hit 6,600, in fact, continuing the rally above 65, which was a tough resistance just days ago. Now, in terms of technicals, which direction is likely? A break into 60, 650, 67? Or do you see heavy selling possible before we break another high?
If we're going to look at the local market's technicals, so far things have been bullishly biased. I mean, number one, the local market is on an uptrend since bottoming at October 31 last year. And at the same time, the local market was able to get past its recent high, which it established in December 20 of last year. If you're going to look at the local market right now, it is riding upon a dynamic support, which is its 10-day exponential moving average. If you're going to look at indicators, the MACD line is still moving upwards, and its 14-day RSI is not yet at overbought levels or at overbought territory, meaning that somehow there's still room for buying.
Okay.
And finally, as you've mentioned a while ago, the value turnover, so it's good. I mean, if you're going to take out the block sales, the net value turnover is going to be at above 4 billion pesos.
And that's still okay?
Yep.
That's still
that
okay,
still
all
okay.
Things considered.
Well, while it is you know, somewhat tepid if you're going to look at the historical average, but it is already a good improvement compared to what we've been seeing before of net value turnover of 2 billion or 3 billion. So far, the technicals are showing us positive signs. Now, moving forward, given these technical signs, these bullish signs that we are seeing, of course, there's still the possibility of profit taking or possibility of pullback, especially okay. Once the RSI hits the overbought territory. But given this, this bullish momentum that we're seeing, there's the possibility that the local market could reach its next resistance, which is at 6,700.
All right, all things looking good technically. What about macro factors? What are investors pricing in these days? Because you have like inflation and then GDP seem to be headed in the right direction as well. What threats remain in the macro level?
Well, for the on the fundamental side or macroeconomic side, well, first with the fundamentals, I believe investors are pricing in the attractiveness of the local market. If you're going to look at where the market ended in 2023, it was at a PE ratio of just a little above 13 times, and this is below its historical average of about a little above 19 times. This is also below the regional average of around 16 or 17 times, or around those levels of PE ratio. So if you're going to look at it both from a historical and a regional standpoint, the local market is at bargain levels. It's attractive. If you're going to now, with respect to macro, I believe investors have been focusing on the upcoming inflation data, the one that is for December 2023. And I believe many are pricing in the possibility of inflation posting a further decline for the month of December. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what, you know, that's what's bringing the optimism. Now, what threats remain? The threats that remain are those which are to happen this 2024. I mean, so far, the numbers are good, especially if you're going to talk about inflation. But moving into 2024, let's not forget that we still have upside risks. I mean, El Nino is still there, and it could still push, you know, inflation higher moving forward. That's a possibility. And of course, with inflation still somehow a threat, we cannot expect the BSP to immediately pull down rates. Okay. So elevated interest rates might still be there. And of course, all of these could, you know, could somehow slow down our economic growth for 2024. So those are the downside risks that we make.
Okay, speaking of inflation, of course, the final numbers will be due out tomorrow. That's for December as well as for the final year as we factor the December inflation in. Now, which items do you think in that basket would reflect higher prices, and which baskets will counter tomorrow's inflation numbers? What do you think?
Well, for December inflation, we are projecting it to hit 4%. We saw a lot of, you know, positives. We saw a lot of prices that have declined month on month in December. Agricultural commodities have been mixed. But many were observed to have experienced a decline in their prices. That includes, you know, vegetables, fruits, fish, sugar. Meanwhile, those which posted, you know, higher prices, the likes of rice and pork and chicken. If you're going to look outside the agricultural commodities, we saw electricity rates decline. We also saw a decline in oil prices. And finally, we saw a strengthening of the local currency.
Yeah.
So that's where the supply, those are some of the factors. For the demand side, of course, we expect a surge in demand given the driven by the season, driven by Christmas. But overall, taking all of these into consideration, we think, or based on our projections, inflation has declined last December.
All right. Lastly, Japhet, while many investors are looking to big names still as they re-enter the markets now, I've been wondering, how the mid-cap board is doing under this rally. Are there specific mid-cap names seeing significant action? Is it wise to even start buying them again?
Well, we've been checking the local market, and so far it's still the big names that are being bought by investors. I believe investors, given the risks that I have mentioned a while ago as we move into 2024, I believe investors are still being cautious with their positioning. I mean, they are optimistic. They're optimistic that, you know, that we're going to see improvements this 2024. However, given the risks, they're still, you know, being cautious. And when you say cautious, they're being picky with respect to, you know, what stocks are they going to buy. And of course, for now, they're going for the ones which are fundamentally, relatively fundamentally stable, which is the big caps. So it's still mostly the index members that are seeing action. But if we are to look outside of that, we're considering the ones that, you know, the index members before, you know, that were taken out. I mean, we can also see value in them. Those are stocks that investors may also want to consider, the likes of Mega World, the likes of Aboitiz. Those are some of the Aboitiz Power Corporation. Those are some of the stocks that are outside of the index that have value that we believe investors can still look into.
All right, Japhet Antiano, Field Stocks Financial. It was a pleasure talking to you again this year. Thank you so much.
You're very much welcome, Stanley. Happy New Year again.
Happy New Year to you.